Let me see if I understand the point you're trying to make. I take it I'm being blamed for Birdsworth's hospitalisation.
We're not the only ones improving.
Not that I need to explain, but if you're looking for someone to blame, then I suggest Gaffney is your logical choice.
Bull.
Oh, it has to be, ladies. You see, I was only doing my duty within the regulations. And if there's one thing I know, it's regulations. Mind you, when I find out who it was who attacked me, I might just have to bend a regulation or two.
All I'm saying is that your attitude to this house has changed since Melissa's arrived.
Yeah, you're right. But things have changed. Judy, I'm seriously thinking of leaving and going to Sydney with Melissa.
Trap?
Oh, I'm not having a very good morning, Miss Ferguson. First I was running late, now somebody's knocked into me.
Well, you're having a better morning than Birdsworth. At least you're still here.
Oh, poor old Lizzie. Well, what did you mean by that?
Well, let's just say that where Birdsworth's been called to, she won't be enjoying the mornings. Not like you, anyway.
Called to?
Mm.
Called to?
Never mind what it means, Trap. Move along.
But what about...
Move it, Trap.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Hey, look at that. She's got two soaps in there. Can I have one?
I've gone. Ferguson reckons Lizzie's dead.
When?
Reckon it happened in the night.
Oh, Jesus.
She didn't want to say it either. She clammed up when I started asking her questions.
Oh, no wonder when she's responsible.
Wish I'd never thought of going over that bloody wall now.
Well, it's not your fault. You didn't push her off the ladder.
No, leave that to the bloody screws.
Well, one screw.
A murdering bitch.
Trouble is we can't do nothing about it.
Well, yes, we can. We can give Lizzie a bloody good send-off.
Oh, yeah? How?
I don't know yet, but I reckon breakfast would be the best time, when we're all together.
Come in.
Come on. You don't want to be late.
Don't even want to go.
Look, it'll be over and done with in no time.
I'll get there in time, Tony, please.
When you get over this morning, you'll have a bit of time on your hands.
I suppose so.
Perfect opportunity to do a bit of study. Keep your course up.
My course is finished.
You're being a bit hard on yourself, aren't you?
I'm going to come out of this with a record. I can hardly join the legal profession.
Aren't you doing some other subjects?
Tony, you know I had my heart set on law.
Well, you can rethink things.
Look, I'll never make it in law and I don't want to do anything else. Thanks for trying.
Well, they all seem to have survived the night.
Yeah, some better than others, I guess.
Yeah, Sarah Hamilton's not too good.
Is she still depressed?
Giving up, I think.
That poor kid, you know. I wish we knew more about her background. At least if we knew something, we might get her to think positively about her future, you know? Tony.
Sorry, Jude.
Melissa again?
Well, I do have a future of my own to think about. I guess you don't need to know about that at the moment.
I'll just be glad when you've got everything sorted out and you're with us all the time that you're here. That's if you intend to stay on.
Well, I'll let you know as soon as I can, Jude.
Yeah, sure.
Keep it moving, Latham.
Oh, watch it, you
just
silly...
Just get to your place. Hurry up, Dobbs.
Well, what are you going to do about Lizzie, Margaret?
You'll know when the time comes.
Excuse me, Mrs. Powell.
Look at the bitch. Hasn't even got the decency to look like she's upset.
Parole board's here. What would you like me to do with them?
Just take them straight to the governor's office. I can't leave here. Something's brewing.
Oh.
Gaffney! All of you, just cut this out and get on with your meals. Stop it!
Do you want any help?
On, but I've got a clue. Well, look, just lock all the security gates, keep the parole board in the reception until we get this car.
Right.
Can't conduct a hearing with this going on.
Afraid not, sir, when Smith and her friends play up.
You mean Beatrice Smith?
Yes, sir. I'm sure she and her push are involved in all this.
You think she's the source of this disturbance?
Oh, would be very difficult to prove, sir.
I'd like to consider reconvening tomorrow. It could take most of the day to get the problem sorted out and the women settled. Would you agree?
Yes, it's possible, sir.
Tell Mrs. Davidson we'll check later to see if that suits her.
Yes, sir.
I said, Lizzie is all right.
Then how come Ferguson told Mouse she was dead?
Lizzie has just spent a comfortable night in the hospital.
How do we know you're not making that up?
I'll check then. If the rumour is true, you can mark Lizzie's passing any reasonable way you like.
You're a witness to that, Mrs. Morris.
I suggest you all resume breakfast before somebody is charged.
Yeah.
Come on, girls. Let's have a nice cup of tea. And a few little questions to the one who spread the word.
Well, it's what I was told.
No, Mouse. I reckon it was what Ferguson wanted you to believe. You've been had. And so have we.
You're going out. Don't be late. Hi, Driscoll House.
Oh, Tiny, it's me.
Oh, Melissa.
Listen, we've got to talk. Have you got a moment?
Well, I'm on my own, as a matter of fact. Judith's taken someone to court. But if it's important...
If you think we're important, it is.
Well, you know I do.
Well, look, Tony, I know how you feel about your job now, and I respect that. But I can't keep on playing second fiddle forever. And I think that's something you've got to respect.
Look, Melissa, it's not as open and shut as that.
Well, I think it is, Tony.
Oh, can you just hang on for a minute? Morning. I wanted to see Sarah Hamilton. Oh, you must be Alan Jeffries.
Yes.
Hi, I'm Tony Berman. I was trying to contact you yesterday. You've just missed her. She's gone to court.
Oh, I thought I might catch her before she left.
I'm afraid not. Well, I don't know how long she'll be. Why don't you give the courthouse a go?
I'll try a little later on.
All right. If she comes back, I'll tell her you called.
Thanks.
Thank you. Sorry, Melissa.
Oh, why don't you ring me when you've got more time?
I don't know what started it. First I knew, everyone was banging things.
So you joined in?
What do you expect me to do with Lizzie dead? She was a mate of mine, Mrs. Powell.
What makes you think she's dead?
What? You say she's not?
Well, she was sitting up in the hospital having breakfast just half an hour ago.
I don't believe it.
We've checked. Now, what made you think she was dead?
I was slipped a note last night.
A note?
That bitch. That bloody bitch.
Come on, Smith, what are you talking about?
That mongrel. Even I don't believe how low that woman will stoop.
Yes, all right, all right. Now, what was in the note?
Who's my best mate, Mrs. Powell? Lizzie, right? And what have I got coming up today? My parole hearing. Now, what is the thing most likely to make me tell the parole board to get stuffed? Lizzie's death, right?
Yeah, suppose so. But what are you saying?
What I am trying to say... Oh, never mind. I'll fix it myself. I'm sorry about the noise, Mrs. Powell. It won't happen again.
Now, listen, Smith. I want you to stay out of hot water. If you've got a problem, that's what I'm here for.
There's no problem, Mrs. Powell. No problem at all.
Well, your hearing's been postponed. You'll be told when it's reconvened. But please, just stay out of trouble.
Now, I'm asking you for the last time, Mouse. What did she say?
Oh, she said Lizzie wasn't with us anymore and wasn't enjoying the morning like the rest of us.
And that's all?
Yes.
And you spread the rumour from there?
Oh, she said it like it was real final. I said Lizzie'd been called away or something.
But that's all.
Yeah?
I have never heard of anything so stupid. You have upset the whole place for nothing.
Oh, I didn't know I was doing that, Mrs. Morris. I just thought that
well,
I was...
Well, don't think. And don't ever be so silly again. Now, the next time you hear something, for God's sake, check on it before you act.
I've never seen Mrs. Morris so cross.
What do you reckon, Mouse? You go off half-cocked and get the whole place in an uproar.
Oh, it's not that. She don't like the freak any more than we do. And it's the freak that's caused all the trouble. But you were dopey enough to fall for the bloody trick.
Oh, I wasn't
don't
dopey,
argue,
I just...
Mouse. Ferguson just sucked you in.
Oh. Well, do you want some coffee?
Thanks.
Hi. How did it go?
The case was adjourned. Sarah's been remanded into our care.
Congratulations, Sarah. Well, that's a lot better than jail.
I'm still going to get a conviction, though, aren't I?
Oh, don't be so gloomy. There are 1,001 technicalities you can get off on.
Not with my luck. Do you mind if I ring Alan?
No, of course not.
Oh, he called to see you this morning.
Thanks.
Oh, let's let her get on with it. Listen, what'd you find out from him?
Who?
Alan. Did you get any information about Sarah?
No, I didn't think to ask him.
Well, why not?
Well, I was on the phone to Melissa when he arrived.
Tony, we need all the information that we can get to help Sarah.
I'm sorry, dude. I just didn't think.
Yeah, well, you haven't been thinking about anything, have you, except yourself?
Look, I'll be okay as soon as I get myself sorted out.
Oh, yeah, and when's that going to be?
Today, I hope. I was wondering if I could have a little time out to go and talk to her. Clear the air.
All right. Anything that's going to get you back on deck's worth a try, I suppose.
Okay. We'll try not to be too long.
Well, is he coming?
Yeah.
Then don't look so gloomy. You're going to feel terrific when you see him.
I'd like a word with you before you go.
Of course.
Did you start the rumor about Lizzie Birdsworth being dead?
Beg your pardon?
Trapp said you told her Lizzie was dead.
Oh, Trapp's got a brain the size of a retarded sparrow. Don't tell me you believe what she comes up with.
What did you say to her?
When?
This morning.
Oh, well, I saw her on her way to the shout.
Hmm. What did you say?
Well, Trapp was whinging about how tough things are in here. I just told her she was a lot better off than Birdsworth.
What on earth made you drag Lizzie's name into it?
Look, I don't know what you're getting at, but it was perfectly valid within the context of the conversation. Trapp has put her own stupid construction onto it.
Well, Smith was also told that Lizzie was dead. Someone slipped her a note.
It's got nothing to do with me. Nor is this Trapp nonsense. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have work to do.
Well, that's the same story Mouse told.
Close enough. And as usual, Joan picked exactly the right person.
I'll bet she dropped that note in on B2.
And won't we be able to prove it?
Well, of course I didn't mean to leave you stranded on the phone. There was a problem.
There always is.
Melissa, it was work.
You're working 24 hours a day,
Well, that's the sort of job...
How's it going?
Not the best, Maxie.
Well, a cup of coffee will fix things.
Maxie, scram.
What? But I just got home.
Oh, just get out, will you?
But I was only going to make a cup
of... If you want a cup of coffee, go around the corner.
Well... If your deep and meaningfuls are too deep and meaningful for me to hear, I'll piss off. I can take a hint. See what I mean? 24 hours a day.
All right. What do you want me to do? Give up work?
No, but you get too caught up with it. I have to compete with every deadbeat for 5 minutes alone with you.
Ah, now we're coming
to... It's
true! It's not true! Look, sure, I'm involved with the people I work with. That's the sort of job that it is. You've got to understand that.
All I can understand is this job is an emotional drain on you. I don't want you when there's nothing left, Tony.
Oh, so you came to take me away from it all?
Only because I can see what this job is doing to you.
Well, this is where I want to be. You can forget your nice safe jobs and your 9-to-5s and your brick veneers. I like this job because it helps people. And I intend to keep on doing it.
Is that all you have to say?
Only that I love you.
Then it's your choice, Tony. Safe to come in?
Yeah, it's safe.
That means she's gone.
Yeah.
What are you up to?
I'm drinking rum. That's all we got left. It was a great thing for the Navy in the old days.
Yeah, Tony. It ain't the Navy. And it ain't the old days. In fact, it's pretty early for any day.
She's gone, Max.
She might be back.
She's gone her way and I'm going mine. Listen, I'm sorry about kicking you out before.
It's all right. Look, you both got different jobs. Different way of life. Everything's different.
Yeah, I suppose it is.
And I haven't helped much either.
What do you mean?
Well, I've been pretty rough. Pushing myself on you and all.
No, you've been all right. I've been the rough one. Giving you a hard time.
I reckon I needed it.
I only did it so you'd get yourself straightened out, you know.
Yeah, well, I'm on the way.
How's the house, honey?
Not bad.
And the dog?
Looking good there, too.
Oh, well, we've done some good then.
Right on, Tom.
Here's to me then.
Oh, I wish somebody would have a go at Ferguson. I've had a bloody gutful of that.
Well, it won't be B. Smith, and that's for bloody sure.
Oh, Margo, look. Let's have a look at the kids, eh?
Jeez, you're a plucky tar.
Yeah, I know. Good day, Judy.
Hi.
Can I have a little cuddle?
What are you doing with that baby, Latham?
They're all right.
I'll tell you what's all right. You, take that baby and go.
We're only showing it to them. It hasn't got anything catching.
You heard what I said, Stanton.
And what if I don't? What are you going to do? Get out the black glove?
Shut your mouth, Stanton. You're on a report.
Just what do you think you are? Some kind of school bully?
It's enough, Jeannie.
It's all right, Mrs. Morris. I can handle this.
Come on, just move off. Go on.
I don't appreciate your interference. She's still on a report.
It's all right, Joan. I can make out a report too.
Oh, hello.
Hi.
Can I help you?
I'm looking for Sarah.
Oh, you must be Alan.
Yes.
Yeah, I'll get her. Sarah? Hi.
Hi.
Well, kids, let's see what we can scrounge up for lunch, huh?
It was awful, Alan. And I'm stuck here.
I wish there was something I could do.
There is. What about you?
My father's still giving me a hard time.
About me?
What else?
You should stand up to him.
I have. He keeps saying that, well, he got me out of trouble with you once, and I'd be better off staying away.
Don't do that. Don't stay away.
Miss Ferguson also reports that you're insubordinate. If that means I have something to say, she's right. What did you have to say?
When you said we were showing the baby to the others.
Is that all?
No. I said she was behaving like the school bully.
Yes, well, that more or less confirms Miss Ferguson's report. I would advise you to watch your step in future.
So what happens now?
Oh, you can consider yourself officially reprimanded. As far as I'm concerned, that's the end of things.
Thanks, Mrs. Powell. It's really...
I would, however, warn you that the light nature of the reprimand on this occasion is not licence for similar behaviour in the future. Is that clear?
Yes, Mrs. Powell.
Then don't forget it.
You know, explorers on the top of mountains drink rum to keep warm.
So you said.
Yeah, I'm glad I'm not an explorer. There's no rum left.
I reckon you've taken enough to keep out the cold.
Oh, no, I haven't. I think of Melissa, I get cold all over. I want to drink a toast.
Well, not to Melissa time.
Why not?
She's not here. And you said yourself she won't be back.
Well, who is here then? You are. Well, I'll drink a toast to you then.
She meant it.
I do. Here's to Maxie. If I don't ask for promises, you wouldn't run off and leave me, would you, Maxie?
No, Tony.
Good. You are staying, aren't you?
If you want me to.
I do.
All right, then. Well, let's get you into bed. Come on, up you go.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Come on. Buttons first.
You're a good mate, Maxie. You're a good mate.
Oh. Oh.
Oh. Hi, Tom. Look at that.
Oh, yeah. Freaks in the kitchen, it's a revenge on the workers.
Wish I could work out some revenge on her.
Oh, here's someone who'll agree with that.
Agree with what?
Fixing the freak.
As long as it's permanent.
It only took her 6 months to work out what a mongrel the freak was.
Chrissie, she had me over a barrel. I mean, I had to do what I was told.
Yeah?
She did it to everybody, to me, to Chrissie.
Chrissie? What did she ever do to you, apart from rearranging your face?
Well, that $2,000 she did you out of.
Fill her up yourself, Phil. Chrissie never had that sort of dough.
She did.
Shut up, Phil.
Well, what's going on here?
Just a little personal disagreement, Mrs. Morris?
Yes, well, you can take out your personal disagreements on the sheets and the towels. Now get a move on, come on.
Now, since your last hearing, Mrs. Smith, we've given your case a lot of consideration. Unfortunately, you compounded your problems on a previous parole, and by a very serious crime at that.
That was a long time ago, sir.
Nevertheless, it's pertinent to this hearing. And a second murder, a premeditated murder, no matter how long ago, is always relevant. Now, what happened?
That all came out of the trial, sir.
But perhaps not all. Perhaps not the way you felt.
My husband was a... Well, he neglected our young daughter. She died of an overdose.
But this sort of thing happens in quite a lot of families. Young people gain access to drugs with no blame accruing to either of the parents.
He didn't do a thing to stop her. He didn't try to help her. Nothing. He just let her die. His own daughter. My daughter.
That does not alter the fact that what you did was very wrong.
You asked me what my feelings were, sir.
Yes, I did.
Well, that's what they were at the time.
Have they changed?
No, not basically. But I have. I've had a lot of time to think. I know what I did was wrong. And since I've been away this time, all the people, the memories, and the associations have slipped into the past. If you'll just look at my record, I think you'll find it's very different.
I see. Perhaps if you'll give us a few minutes.
Of course.
Ah, g'day. Wasn't expecting you.
No, I can see that.
Tony's not home.
No, I can see that too.
Melissa, I thought... Well, you know what I thought.
You gave me a pretty fair idea of that yesterday. I realize now how seriously you do take your job 24 hours a day.
Do you?
I realize better than you can expect.
So I drank myself stupid last night for nothing.
I spent a sleepless night, sober, yet thinking things over, and, well, this morning I realized I did have some genuine feelings for you.
Good.
And I shouldn't let that interfere too much with your career. That's why I went over to your flat this morning. Now I know how your 24-hour-a-day devotion works in practice.
Look, it wasn't like
I know exactly what it was like.
There have been a good many charges against you since your last parole. What do you have to say to that?
I think you'll find that's true of most long-term prisoners, sir.
To some more than others, perhaps. But tell me about your stint as a journalist.
Well, I had the opportunity to put forward a point of view that people out there don't have.
And you feel you used that privilege wisely?
Not always. Sometimes, maybe I did get a bit carried away with my own point of view.
Something which may not always be acceptable to the people out there.
You can hardly blame me for using phrases like that, sir. I've lived with them for so long.
But they do underline the degree of adjustment you'll have to go through if parole is granted.
Yes.
You're an intelligent woman, Mrs. Smith. I'm sure you realize that we don't go into such great detail in all the hearings. Some we get through very quickly. Usually those in which we see no hope of parole being granted. Now let's proceed.
What do you want?
We reckon you're holding out on us.
Well, what do you mean?
You seem to know an awful lot about a lot of people's business.
My money, for instance?
Yeah, well, I didn't know it was meant to be a secret. How come Ferguson never touches you?
I lost my remission. What do you call that?
I call that Ferguson's way of keeping a good thing going. Anyone else would have got a punch in the guts.
And we reckon there's only one way that could happen.
You've got something on her, haven't you?
Right, you bitch.
Oh, what is it?
I don't know what you're talking about.
What is it?
Nothing.
Come on, who told you?
Nobody.
Oh, well, if no one told you nothing, how come you know?
I bet she's got something out of Ferguson's file.
Right.
That's it. What is it, Fields? We want it.
I haven't got anything out of the file.
Don't lie to me. I'll brain you. It's only a letter or something. Maybe she's got it on her.
Let's have a gander.
No! Come here, please. No! Give me a look. Leave me alone.
Well, it was just a sort of a practical joke that got out of hand, Mrs. Powell.
We're not in a boarding school, Fields.
Yes, well, I guess I did have a bit of an argument.
An argument? That ended with you being stripped and your cell almost ripped apart?
That only happened by accident.
And you're still refusing to say who's responsible? I don't accept what you say, Fields. However, my main concern is that incidents like this are kept to a minimum. There's been far too much unrest in here in the last few days. She can spend the next 24 hours in isolation. I'll speak to her again then.
Very well.
Well, we're almost finished, Mrs. Smith. I'm sorry we've held you up for so long.
That's all right, sir.
Of course, it's only over for today, but there's no doubt that we'll finalise the hearing tomorrow. Are you all right, Mrs. Smith?
Oh, it's nothing, sir. I was rather expecting a decision today.
Nothing on the spot, I'm afraid. You've been involved in so many things. We need time to weigh up all the circumstances.
Well, your son will be down in a moment, Mr. Jeffries.
And is this the only place you've got for me to talk to him?
I'm not obliged to give your son anything. This is a home for women.
And good enough for the sort of women it gets, too.
Would you like to come through, please?
Hello, Dad.
Hello, Alan.
How did you know where I'd be?
Oh, I guessed you'd still be wasting your time with that little piece. Wasn't far from there.
It's not wasting time.
Look, I don't want any messing about. I want you back at university where you belong.
Sarah needs me here.
Oh, you're a fool, Alan. She's trapped you once and she'll do it again. You mustn't let her play on your weaknesses. God knows you've got enough of them.
Dad, I can't be what you want me to be. I hate university. I can't do the work. I'm not going back. I can't.
Rubbish, you're coming with me now.
No, Dad.
I think it's time you left, Mr. Jeffries.
This is a family discussion, and I'll thank you to keep out of it.
Well, perhaps you'd like me to get the cops to escort you out.
You'd call the police into a place like this?
You bet I would.
She means it, Mr. Jeffries.
There's the cause of all the trouble.
It's hardly me who's caused the trouble.
Then perhaps you can explain why my son was in strife after he met you. He wasn't before. You needn't stand there looking like a timekeeper. I'm going and taking my son with me.
No, Dad.
All right. If you prefer that little tramp, that's your lookout. And I warn you, you haven't heard the last of your part in this.
Well, well.
Oh, go away, B.
What are you doing here?
Look, I've had a hard day and I'm in no mood to talk.
Well, I've had a hard day too, and I am.
Look, I don't want to talk about it, all right?
Well, I suppose I'll just have to find out about it from the other girls.
Gee, you want to know everything, don't you?
I do know everything, sooner or later.
Yeah, well, I'm in here for my own protection.
What have you been up to this time?
If I let you know, will you make sure the other women stay away from me?
Maybe.
I've got some information, and they want it.
Who's it about?
Ferguson.
What is it?
I've got some old diaries of hers from Queensland about her activities there.
And you've been holding them over her. Where are they?
That's where I draw the line, B. I'm not saying where I got them or how I got hold of them.
Why not?
It's the only protection I've got against her.
Oh, I see. And you feel secure as long as you're the only one who knows where they are.
Yeah, well, that's right. Look, I've got some papers of my own hidden along with those things. Important things. I mean, if anyone found those, my whole life would be in ruins. And my sentence would be longer.
Yeah, I must be getting old. There was a time I would have made you share that information with everyone.
Yeah, but that's the point, Bea. I mean, if you share that with everybody, I mean, it'd be sure to slip out. I mean, the whole threat's gone.
Yeah, all right, you made your point. But just keep an eye on her, okay?
If we knew what was causing all the problems in this place, we'd find a way to do something positive about it.
You know as much about it as we do, Mrs. Davidson.
What about that assault on Fields? If Mrs. Davidson hears about this, there'll be hell to pay. And she's bound to find out sooner or later.
Don't tell her nothing, Chrissie.
And once it gets official, everyone starts to pay for it.
I don't know nothing, Mrs. Morris.
What's wrong with everyone, Paddy?
Well, I don't know, Mrs. Morris.
Then I suggest you find out. Because if there's a clampdown, you're the one with something to lose. Now, you may not get out of here with a clean sheet after all. Not if they find out you're up to something.
Hey, Paddy, bring us a bit of bread, will you?
Come in, Margo.
Now, in a couple of minutes, you're going to be as good as new.
I wasn't much good even when I was new. I think it's time I gave up the game, Jude.
Yeah, so do I. Now, will you hold still? Oh, hi.
Judy.
How's that feel, darling?
Still sore, but better.
Okay. How was your walk?
Oh, good, thanks. I just wanted to ask you.
Ask me what?
Can Alan stay with me for the night? I really need him here, Judy.
Here, love, drink that. Listen, Sarah, that's against the rules, love.
Please, Judy.
All right, just once, okay?
Thanks.
And you'll have to be out by morning.
So long as we have tonight.
All right.
Thanks.
There.
I should have tried to give it up cold turkey. I've made a mess of that like the rest of my life.
Let's face it, Sarah. Our lives are a shambles.
I ended up on the street in the first place because I left home to get away from her dad. One thing led to another, and it was the drugs. I don't really blame the old man for what I've done, but he was a proper bastard.
If only I could get Dad to understand that I'm never going to make it at university. That I'm a flop.
Not.
In his eyes, I am.
I'm not likely to amount to much either. Customer that punched me up yesterday. He was the last straw. Sometimes I just can't see the point in going on.
Don't say that.
Why not? No one gives a damn.
We do here. Honest.
That scene Dad made was the finish.
It needn't be, Alan.
He doesn't care for me. No one does.
I do.
Yes, but you're the only one. And you're in just as much of a mess as I am.
Well, at least you're trying to give up the drugs. That's a start.
Not much of a one. If that fella had paid me instead of belting me, I would have bought more. I would have gone down again in the long run.
Yeah, but you didn't, did you? And you had the sense to come here.
I've got something we can take.
That's not going to help in the long run.
What I've got in mind, Will.
Look, I tell you what. If you like, I'll stay with you tonight. I think you'll feel better if you get some rest, and things are going to look a hell of a lot different in the morning.
All we do tonight is go to sleep.
Breakfast, Sarah.
If she wasn't on muster, I figured she must be in isolation.
Right. Come on, let's find out what it is she's been hiding.
Somewhere.
problem?
No. Just I was up all night with the new girl. A pro with a drug problem.
How is she?
Well, as a matter of fact, I think she's a hell of a lot better than I am at the moment. I'd kill for a coffee. So, any other problems?
Only mine, as far as I know.
I thought you sorted Melissa out.
It wasn't Melissa. It's a long story.
Oh, God.
God! Right, well, we've got to see Mrs. Davidson. This is just getting out of hand. We just have to find out who did this before something more malicious or violent happens.
I agree, but I don't think a witch hunt is the answer.
Well, I wasn't suggesting that.
Well, that's the way it would look, I'm afraid.
All right, what's the alternative?
We'll keep her in isolation for the time being. That way, nobody will be able to get at her.
But how do we find out what's behind today's effort?
Well, everybody will be off guard if we play it down. That will give you both a chance to watch them. Now, I have some good news for a change. I have a memo here from the department about Paddy Lawson. They are willing to apply to the Supreme Court for a writ of nolle prosequi on her behalf.
She'll be set free without a record.
It seems that way. And the other good news is the parole board seems to be looking favorably on B. Smith's case. She should have the news this morning.
Well, that's the stupidest thing I ever heard. Why, Maxine?
I was drunk.
Drunk, yeah, drunk. That's the number one male excuse, isn't it? How did she react?
Well, she's clinging a lot.
Clinging a lot. Well, I suggest you go straight over there now and uncling her.
Now?
Yes, now. Look, you were no use to me at all when Melissa was here. I don't want an instant replay with Maxine, of all people.
Okay.
Oh, God. Oh, listen, did you wake everybody up?
Yeah.
Has Alan gone?
Haven't seen him.
Well, that'll be my first job for the day, getting the lovebirds out of the nest. Will you go? Sarah? Sarah? Now, come on, kids. I bent the rules for you, didn't I? It's time to rise and shine. Will you two quit clowning around?
And to sum up, Mrs. Smith, we're more than happy with the way you've conducted yourself since we saw you 3 months ago. However, prior to this exemplary period, you do have a long history of troublemaking within the prison, with some outbursts of violence, I'm afraid. Well, of course, we don't see this as a bar to granting parole, where we see a person has made genuine efforts at self-rehabilitation. And in your case, I'm sure they're not just a flash in the pan. You should therefore have no trouble in keeping up the effort till the next hearing, in 6 months' time.
Excuse me, sir, did you say 6 months?
Well, there won't be so many questions the next time round. And I look forward to granting your parole then.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow. They don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.